outside of Avignon train station, ancient sculptures rise up on flattened out sunburnt mesas, still glistening with the steam of newly departed rain. As we near the dark side of the sapphire glazed mountains, their outlines are a muted gleaming in the dampened haze of morning light. Vague and otherworldly, teetering at the edge of a leftover reality, these ancient statues seem incomplete, as if waiting for a resurrected Michelangelo to return them to their glory. March morning mist hovers motionless above these forgotten stones, like a ghost searching for something forgotten, remembered. The train continues winding northward. It begins to rain. Sleet blurs, clings, streaks. A child's opaque finger painting, smearing the view. The stones disappear, the statues lying in wait fade into the fading horizon. Later, after the rain subsides, I see an old rundown ramshackle barn leaning into a field of wheat and frost-burnt haystacks, a ghostly mist rising off the field. It starts to rain in me, just